When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Getting Ready Rags.
Are getting ready indeed to spend the next 54 minutes with one of the most challenging and ambitious American musicals of the late 20th century. Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, here on 88.3 WLIW-FM, Long Island's only signature, one-of-a-kind, syncopated radio stations of the NPR umbrella. And today we are going to look at Ragtime with a score by Stephen Flaherty and lyrics by Lynn Ahrens, a 1998 musical which ran for 2 years on Broadway and spawned a couple of revivals. But one of the reasons we are focusing on this particular show is that the Bay Street Theater in Sag Harbor is doing a production of this through August 28th, and you will not want to miss it if you're a fan not only of this show, but Terrence McNally, who wrote the book, and again, this wonderful score and a groundbreaking American show. So you can visit Bay Street, that's one word, baystreet.org for tickets through August 28th. Well, as you probably know, Ragtime is based on the novel by E.L. Doctorow, which wove this wonderful tapestry of imagined events and real events and real people and imagined people in a historical context around 1904. And we are shown three separate groups, really, a privileged white family in New Rochelle, the black community of New York City, led by Cole House Walker, who's a ragtime pianist, and some immigrants who come over from Eastern Europe to make their way in America. It's kind of a ambitious mashup of Showboat and Fiddler on the Roof. But let us go to the opening number, a little less complicated in this recording. This is a 96 studio recording, a kind of rarity in that it was almost like a well-produced demo 2 years before the show appeared on Broadway, but I like it very much. At any rate, here is the opening of Ragtime.
Yeah. Is it freedom or love that you pray for in your guttural accent? Too late, long gone. A salute to a fellow who hasn't a chance. Journey on.
Is that on the ship going back home?
No. America is home now. We will never go back there.
Look, someone is waving. Where is he going?
He's a fool on a fool's journey. You depart on a ship from a country like this. Why on earth would you want to be leaving? Was it something you lost that you suddenly miss? Are you angry or possibly grieving? Do you see in my face what you've lost, sir? Are you moved by the death ship we sail upon? Well, perhaps you're a man who's in search of his heart.
Of the darkness, one going from
one town into America.
Two men meeting at the moment of a journey. For a moment in the darkness, we're the same.
And what of a people whose boundaries change?
I salute
who
you, my
marry
friend.
So bravely and end up so safe.
May you find what you
I will. Journeying here, my love,
as you go
journeying
on the sea.
We're two ships passing at a distance through the darkness,
one going from
one coming to America. Strangers sharing the beginnings of a journey.
I salute you.
God be with you.
I will miss you
in the darkness of the dawn. Journey on.
Well, that was Journey On, Mark Jacoby and co, Peter Friedman and Marin Mazzie from the 90s. sick studio recording, and that sets the story in motion. Again, there's this family from New Rochelle, and father, as he is called, all the father, mother, brother-in-law, your uncle's mustache. I know that family didn't have names. They just had nomenclature. Anyway, leaves America to go on a journey outwards as Tata, the immigrant from Eastern Europe, comes inwards to America. And one of the great things about Ragtime in the original production is it was as big a star-making vehicle as almost anything that ever opened on Broadway. Here is Audra McDonald as Sarah, a black woman who has given birth to a child through an assignation we'll call House Walker, who's somewhat adrift emotionally and certainly from a support point of view. And she has a son who well might meet a terrible end. But here is Audra McDonald in a Tony-winning performance, Your Daddy's Son.
Thank you.
did we change? Caught in this strange new music, say, was I away too long?
Just like the tune, simple and clear, I've come to hear new music. Why can't you hear the song?
His fingers struck those keys, and every note says please, and every chord says turn.
I knew what love was, but these lovers play new music, haunting me, and somehow taunting me. My love was never half as true. And I ask myself, why can't I sing it too? My life has changed, Sarah, you got to see, Sarah, we got a son, Sarah, come down to me.
Is new music, a moment in which the White family from New Rochelle comes to understand Cole House Walker and his style of piano playing. And historically, you know, if you look at Alexander's Ragtime Band, 1912, Irving Berlin, Ragtime was considered to be way beyond the ken of traditional American music. So Ragtime, the show, uses ragtime as a metaphor for changing time, syncopation, being out of time, being out of sync, an evolving America at the turn of the 20th century. Well, in terms of star makers, there was also Brian Stokes Mitchell as Cole House Walker, and he and Audra McDonald teamed up for this duet, which, you know, was one of the most blazing songs at the end of the 20th century. I think it was briefly a Ford Motor commercial. But at any rate, here is Cole House and Walker singing of their dreams of the future.
See his face.
when he is old enough, I will show him America, and he will ride on the wheels of a dream. To cream, then we'll travel on from there.
California, who knows where?
And we will ride on the wheels of a dream. Yes, the wheels are turning for us, girl, and the times are starting to roll. Any man can get where he wants to if he's got some fire in his soul. We'll see justice, Sarah, and plenty of men who will stand up and give us our due. Oh, Sarah, it's more than promises. Sarah, it must be true. A country that lets a man like me own a car, raise a child, build a life with you.
One of the things about Ragtime, which is currently playing at Bay Street Theater through August 28th in Sag Harbor, go see it, is its palette, its canvas of real life people that E.L. Doctorow set in motion. And we see some cameos. We see Emma Goldman, the great left-wing rabble-rouser of the early part of the 20th century, and Mother's brother, who falls under her thrall the night that Goldman spoke at Union Square.
Massachusetts, where workers stand in front of the looms for 64 hours a week and earn under $6. When the meal gave out short pay, the workers went on strike. We must support them!
It was winter in New York as the snow began to fall, and the workmen's hall had not a seat to spare. When a young man ducked inside just to warm himself was all, the night that Goldman spoke at Union Square.
Yes, this is the land of opportunity, but opportunity for men like Mr. J.B. Morgan.
She was speaking loud and fast through a haze of noise and heat and the smell of sweat and anger in the air. The police were standing by, but the crowd was on its feet the night that Goldman spoke at Union Square.
You too!
And her words rang out like arrows and they pierced. pierced him. He felt flushed and overheated as a boy. As she filled an armor, wound him with a fierce and sudden joy.
She says, brothers, stand together. Truth will bring you joy.
He was calling out her name, shouting what he did not know, and he found that he was standing on a chair. With a heart as clean and new as the freshly fallen snow, the night that Goldman spoke,
"I've been waiting for you
at Union Square."
curtain falls on the end of Act One of Ragtime. Well, the curtain didn't fall. It had a huge set by Eugene Lee with a huge clock in it and all this scaffolding. Curtains don't fall so much in the late 20th and early 21st century, do they? But this is Lawrence Mazelon, your host for Broadway to Main Street. And today we're taking that road through New York City, Atlantic City, New Rochelle, and looking at Ragtime, currently playing at the Bay Street Theater. Well, one of the things I loved about Ragtime was, again, these supporting characters who were historically accurate. You had Evelyn Nesbitt, who was the focal point of a love triangle in which her fiancé was shot, and Harry Houdini, the great master escape artist. And they had a song that was cut, unfortunately, in Toronto in the pre-show called The Showbiz, which I like very much. And here is Jim Cordy and Lynette Perry to sing it.
I'm buried alive, I hang by a thread, and people pay money to see if I'm dead, like Mama once said. That's the showbiz.
I'm packing them in from summer to fall, come May, and I'm playing a half-empty hall. Well, you said it all.
That's the showbiz.
It's sad.
It's strange.
Times change and change and change.
And still I'm on top.
I'm third on the bill.
I'm ready to stop.
I'm nervous, I will.
And both of us still in showbiz.
I'm out on a ledge wrapped up in a chain and starting to think as it's starting to rain. My life is insane.
That's the showbiz. My partner's a dud, my gown doesn't fit. The band is demanding a grand or they'll quit. My lawyer does shit.
That's the showbiz.
It's sad, it's strange. Times change and change and change.
I'm losing my head.
I'm losing my voice.
I'm using a chair.
I lost the Rolls Royce.
But what other choice than showbiz?
I'm only a sham. Well, that's my appeal. The people need sham, cause the world is too real.
I know how they feel. I sit and reflect up there on my swing. Stenography lessons might just be the thing. I wish I could sing.
A 100 years from now, the name Harry Houdini will be gone and forgotten. And it wasn't even my real name. And Mama is gone.
My Stanley was shot.
But we carry on.
For like it or not,
we're lucky, lucky we got the showbiz. Where if you are down or dead on your feet,
or hear from some elderly dear on the street that you're obsolete,
that's okay. Cause sad.
Well, Ragtime didn't have many cover recordings. It wasn't that kind of show. It had a studio recording. It had the cast album, which I think is a little long, frankly, for cast albums. But here is a concert in honor of Stephen Flaherty and Lynn Ahrens. And here is the original Cole House chorus, Brian Stokes Mitchell, Stokes, and LaShawn's filling in for Audra McDonald. And this is a song I suspect was added in the second act to give them more to do.
What's your name?
Sarah.
I'm Cole House.
I know.
There was no music in my heart tonight. Melodies kept refusing to flow. One look at you, now every note feels right, coming out all sweet and slow.
You tell stories like your hands play tunes.
Sweetest tune I know is Sarah Brown Eyes. Don't be shy now, Sarah Brown Eyes. Ought to take a chance. The stars are silver notes across that sky now, Sarah Brown Eyes. Come, let's dance.
I never heard no music quite like yours. Where'd you learn how to play it that way? Was I smart? I'd walk right out those doors.
Then I got to make you stay.
Nothing for it but a ragtime tune on that piano. Now, Sarah Brown Eyes ought to take a chance. The stars are silver notes across that sky now, Sarah.
Anyone can get lucky in America. I remind myself of this every day. The first nickel I ever earned, I keep in a little silver frame. It's how I gave my company a name. Reminding me how very far I came. I was a maker of the silhouettes who made a small improvement. A little book of silhouettes that simulated movement. Well, people seem to like it. Soon the money's going clink. And I'm Buffalo Nickel Photoplay Inc. I go from silhouettes to photos. I invent a small projector. And soon I'm making movies and they're calling me director. An industry is dawning and I'm standing on the brink. Mr. Buffalo Nickel Photoplay Inc. Life shines from the shadow screen. Comical yet infinitely true. People love to see what people do. Hear what everyone is someone new. Such tales from the shadow screen. Little men who never get the breaks. Fighting until something finally takes. What a lovely movie it all makes. Well, business is booming, I'm happy to say. I just made a contract to film for Pathé. A series of chapters that end in suspense. Each week see what's next for another 5 cents. And I am waking every morning filled with such anticipation. I frame the sea, I frame the sky, and this is my vacation. I shake your hand, I kiss your hand, I buy you all a drink. And maybe if you chance to see a movie that was made by me, remember when the name goes by, that's Hashkenazy.
The barren now American who happened once to think of silhouette and flicker book and movies as they're meant to look in Buffalo Nickel. Buffalo Nickel, photoplay ink.
That is Peter Friedman as Tata, who becomes an early movie mogul with Buffalo Nickel Photoplay Inc., another part of the Ragtime story that tells the story of how immigrants to America, particularly at this time, this was the largest influx of Eastern European immigrants, made their way to the top. Well, another person who became a superstar through this show was Marin Mazzie, who unfortunately left us a couple of years ago. She appeared on our show, and here she is at the same concert at 54 Below, singing two of her major songs back to back. I often think when you play renditions of people performing, it's fascinating to catch them 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, in this case, I think maybe a decade after they originated a role and really embroidered it in their DNA. So here is Marin with a doubleheader from Ragtime.
Happiness seemed never ending. I was so sure that where we were heading was right. Life was a road so certain and straight and unbending. Our little road with never a crossroad in sight. Back in the days when we spoke in civilized voices, women in white and sturdy young men at the oar. Back in the days when I let you make all my choices. We can never go back to before. There was a time my feet were so solidly planted. You'd sail away while I turned my back to the sea. I was content, a princess asleep and enchanted. If I had dreams, then I let you dream them for me. Back in the days when everything seemed so much clearer, stared from the mirror. We can never go back to before. Mm-hmm. are people out there unafraid of revealing that they might have a feeling or they might have been wrong. There are people out there unafraid to feel sorrow, unafraid of tomorrow, unafraid to be weak, unafraid to be strong. There was a time when you were the person in motion. I was your wife. It never occurred to want more. You were my sky, my moon, and my stars, and my ocean. We can never go back to before. We can never go back to
story. Let it echo far and wide. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. How justice was our battle at, how justice was denied. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. And say to those who blame us for the way we chose to fight, that sometimes there are battles that are more than black or white. And I could not put down my sword when justice was my right. Make them hear you. Go out and tell the story to your daughters and your sons. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. Tell them in our struggle we were not the only ones. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. Your sword can be a sermon or the power of the pen. Teach every child to raise his voice, and then, my brothers, then will justice demanded by 10 million righteous men. Make them hear you. When they hear you, I'll be near you again.
That was Quentin Darrington as Coalhouse from the 2009 revival. His cri de coeur, his way of resonating his mission for Black Americans beyond the personal tragedy that occurs to him in Ragtime. Well, again, Ragtime is playing at the Bay Street Theater through August 28th. You can go to baystreetoneword.org and order tickets. I urge you to do so because it's an important show, very much a part of what I think American Musical was trying to do in reaction to those big British shows of the 1980s. Here is the composer, Stephen Flaherty, showing us how he got inspired to write the opening number. And Ragtime, the music, will always be part of the American scene, and I hope Ragtime, the musical, will always be part of Broadway and Main Street.
It's always exciting when you find the first notes of a show, and these are actually the first notes to Ragtime, so clearly this was the music comes first for this particular song. But this is before words entered it, so I'm going to play you the first notes and then a little bit of a piano solo following.
Thank you.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.